Hello everyone, I welcome you to my YouTube channel Metamorphosis again, and today I am coming with a new kind of video. You know that one day back there was an exam of Jawahar Navodaya Vidhyalaya, and you know, before that exam used to be in paper mode earlier, but in since last 2-3 times it is in online mode. So now getting paper is a Herculean task in present scenario, but still we could recall some of the questions, and we are going to discuss more than 40 questions here which are totally based on memory, but it will help all the students or aspirants of JNV exam, those who have given their time and who have appeared in the exam. So I am going to start, and all the questions are memory based, and it is a, you can take it as a tentative answer key of all the questions which are memorized by us. So let us start that first question. That one of the question which was asked there was, which poet's poem introduced child is the father of man? Dear learners, it is very important line, and you know that it's a poem of Wordsworth, My Heart Leaps Up. From this poem, this child is the father of man is asked, and the poet is William Wordsworth, and this is very important line which have been asked many times even in interviews of JNV. As I was a lecturer in JNV earlier, so I resigned from there, so I know that this was asked from me also to explain actually in the interview, so this is very important. The next question was subtitle of Prelude. You all know that Prelude was a poem which was which Wordsworth kept on writing throughout his life, and it was published posthumously also, The Growth of a Poet's Mind. It has many books, so it's a subtitle is The Growth of Poet's Mind, and it's totally autobiographical poem, and it is very important poem. Then one more question was asked there, that in Kubla Khan, which was, you know, a very good romantic work by Coleridge, and with this work it is said that Coleridge dreamt, and while he woke up he was in the hallucination. You know, Coleridge used to take lot of opium, and so in that he started writing his dream in the form of poem, which was a Kubla Khan. And while he was on his writing task, a passerby actually stopped him, and he said that he asked one address, and while telling him the address, he tend to forget that poem, and poem remained actually incompleted. So this was a famous poem, Kubla Khan, and there the Kubla Khan's palace is in Xanadu. This is a dome actually, and where the river which is flowing there, on which it is situated, is Olf River. So this is answer of the question. Lyrical ballad, it was published in 1798, and it was actually the formal startup of romanticism, where Coleridge and Wordsworth actually collaborated. Coleridge had 4 poems in that, and Wordsworth wrote 19 poems, the first poem being Rime of the Ancient Mariner, very important poem from Coleridge. It is poem which intermingles supernatural elements also. Pindaric is a form of ode. You know that Horatian ode is there, Pindaric ode is there. So Pindaric actually is a form of ode. Next question is Viat and Surrey. Viat and Surrey, actually they introduce 2 things, sonnet and blank verse. Here it was asked sonnet, and the only option was Viat and Surrey, so we could just tick that. And though Surrey was also responsible for bringing blank verse there, which was later mastered by Christopher Marlowe, who was a university wit, you know. Frankenstein is a work of Mary Shelley, and you know that it actually satirizes the Gothic novels. It has connection with Jane Austen also. Jane Austen actually wrote connected with this also, Frankenstein. Revolt of Islam is a religious as well as controversial subject, which was written by, you know, P.B. Shelley, and it was very important. And Prometheus Unbound is a work by P.B. Shelley again, and The Mask of Anarchy is again P.B. Shelley, and Then there were questions regarding the elegies. So Shelley's one elegy, Adonis, was written for Keats, actually, John Keats. And this way, lot many elegies are important, like Lycidas of Milton, Thyrsis of Arnold. They may be asked. You should prepare for them also. Milton's Lycidas and Arnold's Thyrsis are examples of elegy. That was the next question. Hero Pip is a very frequently asked character. It was introduced in the work of Dickens, Great Expectation, actually. And this has been asked many times in other competitions also. So a very important question. R.K. Narayan, you know, that is famous for actually regional novels, regional stories, as it was with Thomas Hardy, who used to write Wessex novels. So in R.K. Narayan's stories, there was a region which is imaginary, Malgudi, which is situated in, in imagination, Mampi forest near the border of Mysore. So it is actually in Mysore. The right answer is Mysore. So again, next question was a comic character which comes in two times in a play. So that was Falstaff. And very interesting incidents with this, that when Henry IV was written and Falstaff was introduced, he was a fat knight and who used to just accompany Henry IV and used to accomplish nonsense tasks, and people actually liked him. Elizabeth also liked. So after that, in the next play, Henry V, Shakespeare didn't introduce him. So Elizabeth called Shakespeare and she demanded that, "I want Falstaff at any cost." So Shakespeare wrote Merry Wives of Windsor, then Falstaff was again introduced. So two times he was introduced. Next question was setting of Hamlet. Setting of Hamlet, everyone knows that it was in Denmark. And then mother of Hamlet, she was Gertrude. You all know that, on which there was a famous quotation that, "Frailty, thy name is woman." Then there was a question, which theater was established in 1576? Its name was The Theater, and it was a second theater at that time in Elizabethan age. Earlier, the first one was The Red Lion. After that, it came The Theater. Dark comedy of Shakespeare is known as Measure and Measure. And Comedy of Errors is a story of twins, actually. That's why somewhere error occurs always in the drama. It is a comedy. And you all know that classical rules, which were given by Greeks, are the unity of place, unity of time, and unity of action. In unity of place, you know that the place where the play is being set should not be, in far away places. It should be somewhere in nearby places of the setting. Time should not exceed more than 24 hours. And action says that the main action line should go with the hero, and there should not be subplots, or action should not actually divert. So this was classical rules. Alexandrine stanza is also called Spenserian stanza, because you know that Spenser introduced two lines in Rhyme Royal of Chaucer, and then in the last line, which was ninth line, he used Alexandrine, which is actually iambic hexameter, where six iambic meters are used. So this was the rhyme scheme was AB, AB, BC, BC, and BCC. That last C one has actually six iamb in that, which was called Alexandrine. Endymion by Keats was published in 1818. Rosalind is again famous character of As You Like It. You know that As You Like It, a very famous poem, and where from one part of which is again casted into a poem of seven ages. And this is actually the same drama. Here Lies One Whose Name Was Writ in Water is epitaph for Keats, where John Keats' grave is situated. In that, on that stone, it is engraved there, "Here Lies One Whose Name Was Writ in Water." Father of English poetry, as you all know, that Chaucer is called. Then Indian Jewish poet is Nassim Ezekiel. You know that The Night of the Scorpion is a very famous poem. Then again, a question was there on the same author, which Indian poets got Sahitya Academy Award in 1983, Nassim Ezekiel. Then again, which novel of Anita Desai got Booker Prize from Indian literature again in 2000? It was a novel, Fasting Feasting. Anita Desai being a very important writer, along with Kiran Desai, all the aspirants must go through the work of both mother and daughter. The Room on the Roof is a famous work by Ruskin Bond, where Rusty is the character, you know that, and Mrs. Kapoor is also a famous character. Autobiography of an Unknown Indian, Niraj C. Chaudhary. It is a famous work of Niraj C. Chaudhary. This question has been asked many times in many exams, so one important one, you should see, you should explore this question more. Which poet's fictional work got first Sahitya Academy Award was R.K. Narayana. You know R.K. Narayana, who in starting struggled for becoming famous, then after he got connected with Green in England, and then he published his work firstly in England and then he became famous. Penthesocracy was used by S.T. Coleridge, and actually one more person was involved with him, Robert Southey, and they were working on the utopian thought that the government should be equal, or equal rights should be given to all. So this was a kind of utopian thought they worked upon. So this philosophy they said Penthesocracy. And there was a famous line, alone, alone, all alone. This was in quite interesting poem of Coleridge, which was Rime of the Ancient Mariner. These are lines. Some more famous lines from there are asked many times, water, water everywhere, not a single drop to drink. This is again one more important line. And the bird introduced by Wordsworth in his poetry was cuckoo. Many times he has created poems on that also. And farce is actually a form of comedy, which is supposed to be very equal to or equivalent to lampoon, where it is not kind of very good humor intermingled with wit, but rather it is supposed to be quite indecent in nature, or you can say that kind of not very decent one, and just for the sake of only cracking of laughter in any way, by hook or by crook. This is farce, one form of comedy, farce. Then Uriah Heep is a famous antagonist of David Copperfield, which was written by Charles Dickens, who is known as the writer of character. And then second last question was about which movement came first, Imagism, Impressionism, Expressionism, Dadaism. You all know that Amy Lowell and Hilda Doolittle and all these were connected with Imagism. Impressionism, you all know that Paul Gauguin, he was a painter, it was a painting movement. Expressionism, Vincent van Gogh, painting movement. Dadaism, you know, all those writers who tried to actually convey the fragmentation of society, and they used to pick up the headlines of the newspaper and used to create poetry. They were called Dadaist during the 1917. And last question is the writer Edward Mars. Actually, he belonged to the Georgian age. So these were somewhere 41 questions, which were totally based on memory. So maybe some questions we missed it, or maybe some questions were misarticulated, but this work was totally done on the basis of memory in order to help all those who have appeared in this test. So I hope that you will get help from this, and it may help you in matching your answers. And thanks a lot. Have a nice day. We'll be coming or meeting again with a new kind of video. Thank you. Thanks a lot.